you knew that into what times you were cast, I could make you look about you. Come sear me, burn me, cut me, I fear not.
Methinks I see Mount Calvary, where the three crosses were pitched.
Had I as many lives as I have hairs on my head or drops of blood in my veins, I would give them all up for this cause. For the liberties of England.
Yeah. but against the church, the courts, and the abuse. At the king's gate, some asked of me what he had done wrong. No crime, said I, but he claims the rights of a freeborn John. So I whipped him from Fleet Prison down through Temple Bar, up the Strand, past Charing Cross, to New Palace Yard. A freeborn Englishman, a freeborn son. I whipped him while the crowd sang. Pipes and dust in his eyes. I stood him in the pillory. I gagged him till he bled. He threw pamphlets to a waiting crowd, and I believe a nation read. I whipped him from the prison down through Temple Bar, up the Strand, past Charing Cross, to the New Palace Yard. A freeborn Englishman, a free. Lift him while the crowd sang.
From the old river. They fell upon us, sir. My own regiment, the Redcoats of Colonel Hollis, well, we suffered the heaviest losses. We began to fall back to the town of Brentford, sir. And when Brooks's regiment saw our faces and our losses, well, they began to retreat also. And who could blame them? But Captain Lilburn, well, he rode after us all. He grabbed our colours and bid all those with weak hearts to march back to London, but called on all those with the spirits of men and the gallantry of soldiers to follow him back to Brentford. Well, of course, we all turned and we followed him as a man, sir, and for 5 or 6 hours, without powder, match or bullet, we disputed that town. We hid in hedges, sir, and behind walls. 700 of us fighting many times our number. But in the end, those who weren't shot, sir, they were just drowned in the river. And as I write to you now, sir, Captain Lilburn, a prize prisoner, sits chained as a beast in Oxford Castle.